Hi everyone and welcome back. It's Vicky here, and on the previous video I did show you a close-up look on all the stamps that I got from Pink Fresh Studio. So in this video I'm going to create a window card using some unique stamps and dies from that release. So I'm going to cut out a panel from this beautiful cardstock. This is glitter cardstock. It's by Tonic Studios and it's called Sugar Crystal. It actually comes in way more colors. I think there are 12 of them, all gorgeous. And I'm going to just cut out here a panel that's exactly the card size. So that's 4.25 by 5.5. And my card base is just made out of heavy cardstock. So you see that it covers completely the card front. And these are my terrarium dies by Pink Fresh Studio. I'm going to place them in a row. I'm running them through my Big Shot. And I'm working on my glitter cardstock at the moment. And with this passing, I do have the windows for my card front, my panel here. And I also get those little frames of the terrarium. So I will make sure to hold on to this since I will be using them later on. And now it's time to do some stamping. I'm placing my panel on top of my card base, so I know exactly where those windows are going to fall. And now I'm going to place those little pots. They fit nicely inside those windows, so this way I get perfect placement. And I know that when I will stick my panel on top of my card, everything is going to look nicely. So I'm going to close my door. Everything is going to stick on the door now. I can remove the panel and start doing my stamping. I stamped the pots first with yellow ink, and now I'm going and adding a little bit of orange only at the base. This way I'm adding just a touch of shadow at the bottom, which is help my pots look more dimensional. And as I'm choosing my plants and which plant will go to which terrarium, I have placed again the window panel on top just to make sure that everything is going to fit inside. And of course you can be neater than me, you can go ahead and add some masking tape on those pots so you can stamp and make all those plants look as if they are coming from inside the pot. I didn't bother to do that. My plants kind of hanging up there, but you will see that they look beautiful at the end. By the way, I'm using my new archival inks to do all the inking today. And here I'm doing again the same technique where I'm adding a darker color in some areas of my plants, which is going to add some shadow. This is a really quick and fun technique to add shadows without doing any crazy coloring. Now I'm going to add one more plant in the middle pot, so I'm masking it with some masking tape. This is actually post-it tape. I'm going to stamp my plant a couple of times, and I made sure to use a darker color of ink so it's going to cover up nicely what's at the bottom. Now the stamping on my card base is done, so let's work on the window now. Now for my windows I usually work with leftover acetate that I have from packages, but I wanted to show you this product that I absolutely love. This is very heavy acetate, it's perfect for construction, and I know that it would make a great box as well if you have those dies to create little boxes. So anyway, this is by Tonic Studios. I don't know if it is yet available in the US. I will make sure to leave links down below for that, as well as for every other product that I'm using today. And if you use this acetate, also make sure to peel off that plastic wrap that is there just to protect the acetate from scratches. So I'm going to cut it to size and I'm going to glue it at the back of my window panel. For that I'm using my white glue. This is the Deluxe Adhesive by Tonic Studios. I'm going to place my acetate on top, and I do have a lovely window card with glitter at the front. And now I need to stick all those terrarium frames on top of those windows. For that I'm using my Nouveau glue pen, and this is the one with the wider tip. I find that this is the easiest way to apply adhesive at the back of such delicate cutouts, and you see that they pop right inside those windows. Now remember that those frames were cut out from the same glitter paper, so they do have shine on them You can't see that on the video, but they really are beautiful. So the idea here is to add some tape adhesive at the back of this panel and then stick it on top of my card base just to add a little bit of dimension. Now the construction of this card would make a shaker card easily, but I decided not to leave and to add any free sequins inside those windows. Instead, I'm just going to glue a few of those pink ones in different areas on my plants to represent the little flowers. And now I can peel off the backing from the tape adhesive and then stick this panel on top of my card base, making sure that I align everything correctly. Now, since I used this glitter card, I cannot stamp on top, but I can always cut out a sentiment and stick it on top, or I can stamp on the inside, which is exactly what I'm going to do. And that was my unique card for today. I hope you had fun, you got inspired. Don't forget to leave me a comment down below, and I'll see you all next time. Thank you for watching.